Good morning, everyone. My name's Superintendent Michael McLean. I'm the commander here at Fairfield City PAC. Excuse me. So at about, or just prior to 2:30 a.m. this morning, police were patrolling the Horsley Drive at Carramar. They've sighted a VW Golf sedan or hatchback on the Horsley Drive. That vehicle was damaged. Its rear bar was scraping on the roadway, and that alerted police to obviously some issues with that vehicle. So police attempted to stop that vehicle, activating their lights and sirens. And then what followed was obviously the vehicle taking off or refusing to stop for police. A very short pursuit ensued before that vehicle approached the intersection of the River Road. And upon negotiating that intersection, collided with the gutter and obviously overturned a number of times. Now, what we know is that at that time, three occupants of the vehicle, the driver and two passengers, escaped from the vehicle. One of those occupants was detained by police at the scene. Now, that occupant, a 13-year-old male from Colby, was assessed at the scene by New South Wales Ambulance, and he was taken to Liverpool Hospital for observations. He's now been released from hospital and is currently at Liverpool Police Station assisting Fairfield City Police with inquiries in respect to of that collision. What we've been able to determine is that vehicle was stolen from the Colby area some hours prior to being sighted by police in Carramar. We are following up inquiries in respect of the other two occupants. And those inquiries will continue throughout the day. Do you have any questions?
How short was it?
Look, it was very short, so less than a minute. So if you'd appreciate, the pursuit commenced on the Horsley Drive, and then the police officer was at a point where he was self-terminating and was unable to get onto the police radio, and the collision occurred. So. No, not at all. So what alerted him to the issue was obviously the damage to the vehicle, and he's simply taken the decision to stop the vehicle based on that damage. It was clear, given the bumper bar, the rear bar was scraping on the roadway, that he should stop the vehicle. The vehicle was not reported stolen at the time, but certainly become aware that there was obviously issues with the vehicle and needed to be stopped.
The challenges expect to be later for the matter?
Yes, look, we expect at this stage that young person will certainly be interviewed, and there's obviously a number of offences which we will consider, but it's too early to say at this stage. He is assisting with inquiries at the police station.
Has been able to tell you anything about the other two occupants?
Not at this stage. Certainly our police will conduct those inquiries, obviously with a view of attempting to identify those other parties.
As an appeal for information, where were they last seen heading to?
Oh, look, just in that general area. They were just, as I understand, just seen on the River Road. But what it does show is that obviously a 13-year-old child, it would be reasonable to suspect, albeit we can't confirm that potentially those other two occupants of the vehicle were also young. To state their age, I don't know, but it's certainly of concern to think that a 13-year-old's out in a stolen car at that time of night, and certainly would take that seriously, and we will pursue our efforts to try and identify the other parties.
Parents or guardians been contacted?
Yes, certainly. That is the case, that we've made those contacts, and that will form part of our investigative process.
Have they offered any comment on the matter?
Look, not at this stage, as far as I know.
A lot of parents are in disbelief that a 13-year-old could be allegedly part of this. Is there a message to parents?
Look, I think this is a very small section of our youth in the community. There are certainly children who do engage in criminal behaviour. We do our utmost as police to try and divert them away from those behaviours prior to these sort of things happening, albeit there is a small element who do continue this criminality and unfortunately will do so potentially throughout life. But our efforts are always considered and around diverting those youth. So certainly the message for parents out there is, if you have concerns, certainly there is support out there if you believe your child is heading in the wrong direction, but that's not the main. We think that that in the main most children are being kids, and that's what we want them to be, and this is an exception rather than the rule. So I don't think it's a It's an overwhelming problem for us in this area, but certainly one which we take seriously.
You mentioned the car has the same damage. Are you able to trace its movements and identify how that was caused?
Look, that will form part of the inquiries, but at this stage, no, we don't know where that damage occurred. But clearly, it'd be reasonable to suspect that that has impacted with something else a short time prior to the collision occurring.
What was the driver's injuries?
So he wasn't the driver. We won't allege that the person we have in custody was the driver, but in fact was a passenger of the vehicle, albeit we will confirm that throughout our inquiries. Look, very minor injuries, certainly to the point where he's now been released and is in custody at Liverpool Police Station.
Do you believe the other occupants are injured?
Look, they were not injured enough where they were stuck at the scene, and they were able to escape prior to police arriving there, and our efforts were only able to obtain or to detain one of those occupants. So no, I don't think their injuries were extensive, but certainly whether they warrant medical treatment or not, I don't know. But I'd appeal for anyone in the area who may have information, footage, whether it be dash cam or otherwise, to come forward and contact police or Crime Stoppers with information about that, because it is dangerous. So that manner of driving is dangerous, not only for the children in the car, but members of the public and broader community. Too early to say, but certainly there's a range of offences for being carried in a conveyance. But we'll certainly progress that through the morning, and where we can identify an offence, that person would in normal course of events be charged. But I won't jump the gun. Obviously, we need to conduct our inquiries to determine if an offence has been committed.
Incredibly young,
I won't comment on that at this point in time. Wouldn't be appropriate.